I think I finally reached that point that I'd like to reach my final conclusion about the coup that happened over the United States government by the judicial branch especially, but also certain members of the Congress, the Senate, and probably members of the intelligence community. All right, so the constitutions they have broken, all of them in general, especially by the Justice Department. Number one, you broke my right to free speech. You censored me and you censored the information that I was getting, so you censored other people's free speech in coming towards me. You broke my right to have a free religion, because if I want to have a religion where I want to take mushrooms, I want to have a religion where I can do some drugs if I want, that's my right, and that's part of my culture, and that's part of my history. You can say, you don't believe in God. So sorry, what is a religion exactly? Lots of Buddhists don't believe in God. Lots of Jewish people don't believe in God. I don't have to believe in God. I can still have a religion. My religion can say if I want to do drugs, I can do drugs. So if you're sitting there going, no, you can't do drugs, I said so, it's like, okay, where in the Constitution? Okay, so basically, you have a weapons charge against me, and I have the right to bear and also to stash guns away. And in California, they say I can't have a right to have a gun. But if there's anybody in the world that needs a gun, it's me. And if there's anywhere in the world I need a gun, it's California, obviously, because I've been in danger so many times in that damn state. So you took away my right to bear arms. That's, okay, so that's just two amendments, even though broke them in multiple ways. I actually think you probably broke this freedom of assembly, because you sure started gassing early. But who knows? I think that a lot of these protesters were probably doing a lot of vandalism. I tried to petition the government, and apparently I got censored. Because if I did a hunger strike and all these people don't know who I am, then how does that work? All right, so you didn't make me keep troops in my home, unless you talk about agents that came and slept with me and then stopped sleeping with me after they slept with me once and they just like lived at my place. All right. Yeah, you definitely broke the Fifth Amendment. That's for sure. Oh, Fourth Amendment for sure, and Fifth. But Fourth Amendment for sure. You broke. You didn't use warrants. You were basically, obviously, you hacked me as a child and put women having sex with horses on my computer before I knew what bestiality was. And I didn't know what bestiality was again until like high school, where I finally found the term again. And I was like, that's what it's called. All right. Fifth Amendment provides that citizens not be subject to criminal prosecution and punishment without due process. Citizens may not be tried on the same set of facts twice. Protects against self-incrimination, so I have the right to remain silent, but it doesn't matter. Okay, that's got eminent domain in it. All right, that's not the one I'm worried about. Sixth Amendment assures the right to a speedy trial by a jury of one's peers. All right, so the big concern about that is I ain't got no speedy trial. You have retrialed me for 7 years straight, right? Probably more than that. Probably before I even knew you existed. You probably had trials going. Did you have juries already selected for me before I even knew the drugs existed? And then next thing you know, this person started like making me think that they were selling drugs with me, and I was like, I'm quitting. I don't want to be around you drug dealers. I was like, I'm not going to jail because of you guys, because I wasn't afraid of her. I didn't think she was gonna snitch on me. I was afraid of the people she was selling to. I was afraid of like the moment I get to someone that's picking up, they were gonna be getting followed, and I was like, there's no way in hell these people are tricking me. All right, so yeah, my understanding is that after, well, what happened is I actually had a lawyer around me for an entire semester, and I asked him a lot of questions, and he did say that they can retry you indefinitely. And I'm pretty sure that's what happened, is they kept doing retrials as long as the judge says you're allowed to. So there's no actual limit on the number of retrials you can have, which is against the Constitution. All right. The amendment also provides the accused the right to compel testimony from witnesses and legal representation. So if there's anyone that needs to be involved with his legal representation, it's me, because I know more about my situation. I actually do know the law. I'm more clever than most lawyers. If there's anything you'll learn real quick about life, is that the way you think about a problem is different than your degree. Like, it's all about like the way you approach things and the way you are, and your ability to actually understand that information. Think about it in based on other information you have. A lot of people can't do that very well. All right. Okay. Eighth Amendment prohibits excessive bail, excessive fines, and cruel and unusual punishment. Okay, so if you're gonna kill, I remember the reason when Cat Tim posted something about death penalty, I thought about it is because I remember Donald Trump was talking about the death penalty a long time ago. I thought that was probably because he was a representative of some people from Ukraine or something like that, or financially, I don't know. Now I'm wondering, what is the national security issue with him? Like, are we just gonna kill him? Like, what are we gonna do exactly? I mean, people like that, you definitely don't let them get around the media, and that's why what I told you a long time ago. Why would you let this guy go around the media? Apparently, you think that he's gonna keep his mouth shut because you think that he's protecting his own ass enough. But I'm real concerned, especially if you ever leave him alone in a room. And I that's what I told the Secret Service. Well, maybe I didn't. I don't think I actually did tell him that. Actually, when I met the Secret Service man, this man, he went to Harvard. He's best friends with the guy who was the computer master at the Secret Service. And he said he liked Trump. It's pretty clear the Supreme Court has violated the Constitution, if there's anything I know, and they know it. And the big issue is like, well, why don't you just like forgive them, put them in jail? Like, I will beg for mercy or something like that. Why don't you just do that? Well, here's the real issue here. You didn't just break the Constitution. You tried to assassinate me to cover up for you breaking the Constitution, but not just breaking the Constitution, murdering, like your people murdering and framing people for terrorism and being that bad, like real, you want to talk about shit that Hitler did? Hitler didn't do nothing. Hitler was a little bitch. Well, he was until he turned into, I'm talking about when Hitler was a fascist before he was a military fascist. That's what I'm talking about. All right. This is terrible. This is the United States of America, and I'm sorry that I ain't prettier.